Welcome to video 11 on Microsoft Flight Simulator. In the previous video, we saw how we can fly straight to or away from an NDB. Let's set ourselves a little different challenge now, and it is to intercept a specific bearing towards an NDB. And while we do it, we'll have another airplane, the Cessna 172, which has an Bendix King KR87ADF. So we'll see how we can operate that. The challenge that we set ourselves is this little flight in Portugal from Biarritz to Vigo. A little north of Vigo there is this NDB, which is perfectly lined up with the runway. We are here flying to the west, and to line up with the runway we need to find the 195 bearing towards that NDB. So the whole question is when to make this turn. Can we see that on the NDB needle? Yes, we can. To see how it works, we can use this very nice simulator on vergones.net. We are here flying to the west and the NDB is over here. The ADF needle shows where the NDB is. Let's fly, and the first thing that we need to do is have a look at our heading indicator and rotate this ADF scale to that exact same position, which is here pure west. Then the needle is slowly crawling towards the intended bearing we want to intercept, which is 195 in our example, which is over here. So we are almost there, and we simply wait until that needle is almost at 195, and we can start our turn a little bit before that, and then make little corrections if needed to get exactly on course. So this is the end result. We have the NDB now straight in front of our nose, and we should be on a heading of 195. This is how we can intercept a bearing to an NDB, rotate this scale until it resembles the heading indicator, and then wait for the needle to get to the bearing we want to intercept. This was the theory. Let's now put it in practice. This is the area in the north of Portugal where we plan our little sightseeing flight. And we start at Biarritz, I don't know exactly how to pronounce it, right click and set as departure. We want to go to Vigo, right click and set as destination, and there we have our basic flight plan. We like to include this NDB, so let me left click on the line and include it. But we like to fly here along this valley, a river with a road that should give a nice scenery. So left click again and then line up with the runway already, and that we like to go from there more or less. So let me now also left click over here and say that I want to fly into that valley that should give nice scenery. And then one more detail, I happen to know that over here they have done something quite crazy. There are a lot of windmills on top of the hills, but they are right in if you depart from this airport you are flying into them. That is not quite handy, so we best make another waypoint and keep a little close to these roads over here. So let me shift this one a little over there, and this should keep us clear from those windmills. Yeah, that is quite close, but just safe. There's another thing, we have a red warning over here. The elevation profile is not okay. Well, that is due to the fact that we are now in a mountainous area, and the 1500 feet that is still over there from the last flight we planned is a bit low. Let's change that to 3000, and that might bring us in safer area. How do I know that 3000 is okay? Well, we can have a look at the elevation window. Go to the window menu and select the elevation profile. That gives us a very nice mountainous area that we are flying over. And we can see this red line is the minimum safe altitude. Yeah, that is because in this little area with the highest mountain, that is the case. But we are just departing from that airport, and we are just getting in the air, so we can't be at that altitude already. And for the rest of the flight, 3000 is enough. And over here, this orange line says for this leg, this should even be a safe altitude. So we can go down a little after our third waypoint, but we are not going to do that. So yeah, look what happens on the map. If you move your mouse over the elevation profile, you see this blue circle going along your flight path. So yeah, that is all a very, very nice built piece of software, this little nav map. One more detail, I'm going to close this elevation profile. One more detail, I want to exactly state the departure position. So like we did before, click this green circle over there, and then I'm going to select runway 35, and that should be okay. And let me zoom in. Yeah, the yellow circle says where we are going to start. Well, let's save this flight plan, file, export as MSFF plan, save it. Yeah, I already have it, so I will get this bleep, and then it's okay. We can open Microsoft Flight Sim and go fly. Let's click World Map, and why is that not working? Yeah, and then open the plan that we just saved, and that was the Biarritz. Where is it? There it is. And what I also did is select the Cessna 172 with the gauges, which is a plane available in the deluxe edition of Microsoft Flight Sim. And let's go fly. Here we are in the Cessna 172, and look what is straight in front of our nose, a couple of windmills. So we best make a curve to the right to avoid them. And then we have this Bendix King KR87 on board, the ADF, and we need to tune a frequency in it for the NDB, and that frequency is on our kneeboard 345. This outer ring that tunes the first digit, and that is now a 3. This inner knob does the other two digits, 5, and if I press it, then it goes to the middle digit, 345. That's it. Then press this frequency button over here to exchange the two frequencies. We can now arm a second NDB if we would like. What is also nice of this little thing is that it has a stopwatch and a clock on board. We can press this button flight and ET. It has now here the enunciator flight, that is the total flight time. If I press again, it is the leg time, a stopwatch, and I can start and stop the stopwatch over here. I just started it with one press. If I press it again, it will stop running. If I press it again, it goes back to zero, and if I press it again, it starts running again. So that's a lot of presses, but we can get that done. So let's press that and have the stopwatch running for our first leg, which should be 1 minute for this very short first part just after takeoff, and then 2 minutes to get around our waypoint 2. So all in all, 2.5 or 3 minutes. So let's start that stopwatch and get airborne. Let's release the parking brakes and go full throttle and see if we can avoid those windmills over there in front of our nose. Okay, I'm doing a little rudder because I'm drifting away otherwise, and that's of course quite normal. Oops, yeah, there we go, 55, go up, and yeah, we are at a positive climb rate. So let me release or put in the flaps, which was on flaps 1. And yeah, we are fine. We can go up, and well, let me have a little look if we are not touching that hill. No, everything seems to go fine. And when we have passed this hill, then I make a little curve to the right. Yeah, that should be more or less right now. And let's fly a little to the right and then avoid that windmill over there. And the course that we need to go from our flight plan, it is 9. Well, let's do that, 9. So let's have a look at our heading indicator. And we are now north, we are now at 9. Well, that's good, let's keep it at 9. We are going to climb to 3000, and we are already over that. Oh, that was a bit fast. Well, then I can throttle down. Let's go to 3500. I see over here that we are already at 3500, and let's enjoy the scenery. I think we are going to do a little slew to make this video shorter. But let's first have a look at that stopwatch of us. It is at 2 minutes 10 seconds, so 1 minute to go before we will be at our valley. I bet this over here is that valley, and this, yeah, this is that little village that was over there. So that's when we are going to make our left turn. Well, maybe just keep flying and do that live, why not? That video is not going to be too long. It's quite nice. This is the drone camera. Let's put it on the tail, or maybe not the tail. Let's look around a little bit. Maybe we can spot that valley. Ah, yeah, now we can spot that valley. Look, that's over there, the river, and that road is all over there. So we are now going to make our left turn more or less right now. Is my stopwatch at 3 minutes? Yeah, it's at 3 minutes, so that's quite okay. Let me put that on 0 and then start it again for the next leg. Why not? Okay, so let's now make the turn. And what is our heading? Our heading is 260. Well, let's do it. Ah, yeah, this is of course a little cheating, but that doesn't matter. We are now going to fly 260. Let's have a look at our heading indicator, and let's keep the plane at vertical speed 0, 260. Well, that should be somewhere. Oh, I was a little bit steep. That should be something like this. And yeah, we are now flying straight over that valley, which means we don't see much out of the window. Not that river anyhow. So maybe it is nicer for the scenery and the views to fly a little bit more to the right, and then we can have a constant view out of the left window to see that nice valley and have a better view of the scenery. And soon we will even reach the water, the sea, which is in front of us. Yeah, now I can see here on the left, I can clearly see that the valley and the river over here. So this is nice to watch. We can have a look out of the window, and we should be able to constantly have nice scenery in front of us. Okay, let's make a little skip, because now the whole purpose of this video was we are on a heading of 260, and we want to intercept an NDB bearing of 1995. And how are we going to do that? Well, we are going to do that, of course, with the ADF needle. And yeah, we are going to wait until it is on 195. Right, so let's do that preparation of the ADF, and we can see that we are flying on our intended course, but I shifted to the right a bit to have a better view out of my left window, which is okay. Now we are going to look out for this waypoint over here, which is the 195 bearing to this NDB. So let's have a closer look at that NDB. What we needed to do is have the ring, the compass ring, exactly the same as our current heading. The current heading is 255, 250, well, it should be 260, so maybe I better change that a little bit to 260 so that we make better use of our intended plan. Yeah, have a look at that heading indicator here. 260, and we have the valley here clearly on our left. That's nice. Okay, 260, and let's put that ADF on 260, and that is by rotating that heading knob, and 260, that is over here. Well, I think I'm more in the neighborhood of, what's happening? More in the neighborhood of 255. And now the needle is pointing to the NDB, and we want 195, which is exactly over there, to be our new heading. So we wait until that needle is over there. So yeah, all we have to do is keep an eye on that needle continuously. And if it is at, look what a nice views here from the sea and the towns over there. It's a little bit hazy, which is a pity, but okay, nice views. We are looking at this needle. If it is at 195, which is over here with the white arrow pointer, yeah, then we are going to make the turn, or maybe just a little bit before, just to make sure that we not overshoot. So yeah, let's keep an eye on that needle. Yeah, I think we are close to 195, close enough to slowly make that turn now, and yeah, then everything should be okay. Maybe we can even see the airport already. I don't know if there's lights in on the airport. We will be, yeah, I already see it, but first we are going to make sure that we are on 195, and we are now on 200. Yeah, let's go on with my curve, a turn, and then yeah, I see the airport over there. So yeah, it is a visual flight with a little help of an NDB. What we did now, let's see if we did a good job over here. Yeah, we did a pretty good job because we are perfectly lined up with our last leg, or not the final leg, but the leg to this NDB over here. Here's the plane, here's the NDB. This looks, yeah, this looks okay, this looks great, this looks perfect. And as long as we can keep an eye here on this airport, let me zoom in, then we can already better see it a bit. There's enough lighting, I can already even see the runway, so everything will be okay. Yeah, no need to prolong this video. We are not going to do the landing. That is for a later video, to use ILS. That's also a lot of fun. So this is what we accomplished. We rotated our ADF needle heading to the exact same position as our heading indicator. And then we made the turn at the bearing that we wanted to go to. When that needle was at that bearing, in this case it was 195, then we made the turn. And now all we have to do is keep that needle straight. Right now I'm drifting away a little bit, but that's because I'm not taking care of my stick. I'm talking too much. Well, maybe see you back in the next video. I'm not quite sure what the subject will be. Maybe we are going to shift to another NDB interception, but now flying away from the NDB, which is of course just the opposite of what we did right now. Maybe see you back there.